guys. Welcome to Level Up TV. Hi. And in this episode, we're gonna be talking about when do you know it's time to level up, okay? Yes, when do you know it's time to level up? We're gonna be talking about it from a spiritual, mental, physical, emotional, and financial perspective. Five perspectives, and all of these perspectives come from the one and the only Level Up TV. Okay, I'm just kidding. We're all leveled up. Everyone who is subscribed to this channel is all leveled up. So let's get into the video, okay? I have my notes here as usual. I'm gonna talk about when do you know the universe is calling you to level up. And when I say level up, what I mean by that is changing your perspective of who you are to become better, not blaming other people for your mistakes, but owning up to what you do and being better than that, being better than who you were yesterday. Not, you know, saying like, not being a victim, not saying that because of so and so, that's why I reacted. Ladies, you know that sometimes we get very emotional when our partners don't treat us the way that we think we deserve to be treated. Not saying that you have to be treated less than, now come on, you are a goddess. But what I mean by that is sometimes your partner might react to you in a certain way based on what's going on with them. You don't always know what's going on with your partner, and I know this for sure, okay, being in the type of relationship I am in. So when your partner speaks to you a certain way and you react to them a certain way, you have to ask yourself, am I reacting to them that way because of myself, or am I reacting that way because it is justified based on their actions? But then again, you can't justify what you do based off somebody else's actions, because that's you making somebody else your creator. Your creator of your reality. If someone tells you that you stink and you get mad at that, you made that person affect what you're doing. If there's somebody tell you you stink, but in yourself you know that, what, I don't stink, I'm the best thing since sliced bread, what do you mean? Then you're not gonna be hurt by their comments. It's all about you, and it's all about how you have your mindset. Okay, what is your mindset? How do you view yourself? How do you view life? Nobody can tell you anything about yourself that you don't already know. You have to know yourself. Okay, so this is what leveling up is about. Leveling up is about knowing yourself and knowing what you can and cannot do, and not feeling sorry for yourself, not feeling bad for yourself. If you can't do something right now, you just can't, okay? Then you find ways to do it. You find ways to do something that is close to it. You find ways to bring yourself closer to that goal. And it's okay if you find stops on the way, because you know that each day you're gonna grow, and each day you're gonna go get over the stops. You're never gonna go back tomorrow. That's what leveling up is all about here on Level Up TV. So we're gonna get into the ways. The first thing we're doing is emotionally. So how do you know that the universe is calling you to level up emotionally? You're going through negative cycles of emotions. You're calling yourself a victim. You feel depressed. You have mood swings, okay? Well, how does that relate to leveling up? Well, when you have negative cycles of emotions, what the universe is trying to show you here is that there is something within you that isn't healed. And this negative cycle, let's say you always feel sad when you do a certain thing, you're gonna always feel that unless you heal that thing that you do that causes you to feel sad, okay? Now you're calling yourself a victim, again, making somebody else create your reality. You know, calling yourself a victim. Oh, this thing happened to me. I felt this way because she said that about me. It's not about that. It's about who you think about yourself and what you create in your reality. You can simply say something else in your mind. Okay, she said that, but was I affected? Did I die though? No. So now, depression. Some people can't control their depression, can't control their thoughts. But if you are someone who is consciously aware of your depression and constantly consciously aware of what causes you to feel depressed, know that depression means I pressed on. Okay, you're gonna press on from this. It's not gonna keep. Depression is only like a downtime. It's a downtime, but you can rise above that downtime through transmutation. Check out my video on transmutation. Also, you can rise above that just by rising above, by just choosing to think that, okay, even if I may feel sad about this, there's something else I can think about that will make me happy. So now mood swings. What mood swings basically means to me is that you are not aligned. Because when you have mood swings, one time you're happy, one time you're sad. What it's really telling you is that you're not aligned with source energy. Source energy is always still. Source energy is always here. But if you are here and there and you're not still and you're not here, you're not in the present moment, that's when you know that you are not aligned with source energy. And then you have mood swings. You go up, you go down. Nothing can really make you happy. Okay? Now financially, how do you know you need to level up financially? You're always broke. You can't make moves. Okay? You're going out with friends. You can't buy drinks. Alright? You gotta save some more. Okay, you're saving, but when you're saving, the money keeps going. Where does the money go? You know, do you spend your money on things that will actually bring you money, or do you spend your money on things that don't? Or, you know, sometimes you could spend your money on things that, you know, make you happy. I spend my money on tarot cards, okay? And I spend my money on crystals. But at the end of the day, I know that there are things that I want to do in my life, so I also have to save. You know, my savings ain't where I want them to be yet, but I constantly tell myself they will be there. So what is even your relationship with money? You know, how do you view money? What do you see money as? Do you think money is something that is constantly fleeting from you? Or do you think that money is constantly coming to you? Even if you spend money, you know, money is just an energy. It's an exchange. You give, you receive that. So the amount you give is the amount you will receive back, if you believe that, okay? So now, are you making wise investments? Are you investing in yourself, first of all? Or what are you investing to? Are you spending money to go to the bar every Friday and drink, you know? Or would you rather take that money and save it to invest in a house or something in the future? Okay, now physically, you're always sick. Okay, you get the flu easily. You can't really have the energy to do the things that you want to do in life. So you're always home, you're always tired. When you wake up in the morning, you're kind of groggy. You can't really, you know, get up on your day as you want to. The universe is telling you it is time to do something different physically to get your body in check and in line. Okay, so you're having body changes. You're either getting more slim quicker, or you're getting more thick quicker. What they're trying to tell you here is that you need to regulate your diet. Okay, then you're pregnant. Okay, for my ladies who are pregnant and you have a child to carry, you have to level up physically because you have another body growing within you. So you're gonna have to take care of not only yourself but of that body as well. And you have to take care of yourself not only physically but emotionally as well. Ensure that your emotions are in check, because the baby is gonna feel that and come out with those type of emotions. That's very, very important. That messes up, you know, the spirits and all of that in the child. I'm serious, okay? I've seen this. Then your appearance is changing. So let's say you're not always looking as good as you used to, or you're looking very good, and that's great. Okay, so you have leveled up. But let's say you're just not looking as good as you used to. You're trying to put on makeup, but you're not feeling good. You're doing something, but you're not feeling good. So that is when the universe is trying to tell you that you need to change how you appear, not only to the public, but how you appear to yourself. Because remember, whatever goes on the outside has to occur on the inside first. So do you even feel beautiful? Do you feel like you can do these type of things? Do you feel like you can appear beautiful? And if you don't, then it's time for you to change how you view yourself. Now spiritually, mentally now, I'm getting ahead of myself. So mentally, are you focused? Are you driven? Where does your mind go to at night? Ooh, I'm going there. what is your mind on? Where do you spend most of your time? Do you spend your time most on social media? Does social media influence you more than a book? Do you read? What do you do? Okay, how are you exercising your mind? That's when you know the universe is trying to level you up, when there's something that's going on within you mentally that you can't figure out and you want to figure it out. But you have to be calculative about it, and you can't be calculative about it because you don't have the knowledge about it. Then the universe is pushing you to gain that knowledge. Okay, that's what it is. You never compare yourself to other people who might appear to have, you know, knowledge about something that you don't have. You don't know what the person had to go through to get that and why they are who they are today. So whenever you compare yourself about, you know, what somebody else might, how their mind is, what you have to ask yourself is my mind where I want my mind to be? And if you are content that you are where you want to be, then okay, great. But then if you say, my mind, actually, no, I'm not quite there yet. I think that there is something else that I want to do with this mind. That there's something else I want to learn. Then you know it's time for you to go the next level, the next step to, you know, increase your mental capacity. So also your passion, you know, where does your passion lie? Are you motivated? If you can't motivate yourself, who's going to motivate you? Somebody can't motivate you every day. You have to get up and motivate yourself. You have to look yourself in the mirror and say, I feel, I am, I do, I speak, I see, I think. Okay? Like, just say different affirmations that allow you to feel that you are mentally okay and you are passionate about yourself and who and the things you do. Now, let's say you have cycles of constant negative thinking. That's when the universe is trying to tell you, like, again, with the negative emotions, there's something within your mental state that has to change in order for you to move to the next level. This thought that you have, it can't go to where you want to go or where the universe wants you to go. Because sometimes we want to go somewhere, but the universe is on a whole different road. And if you keep going down this road, they're gonna do numerous things to push you back on the road that you're supposed to go. I just experienced this not too long ago. Okay, so yes, if you are straying away from the path that you're supposed to go down, the universe will surely put you back on that path. And if you keep thinking about things that are not aligned with that path, then it's gonna be a constant thing that you're gonna deal with until you realize that you have to let that thought go. Alright, so now let's get into how, oh no, I forgot spiritually. I was getting ahead of myself, now I forgot it. Let's talk about when does the universe want you to level up spiritually. You pray, but your prayers are not being answered. Clearly, there's something that you're doing that is not convincing enough to the universe, to God, or whoever you pray to, that what you're doing is not, you know, clear enough. You're not praying clear enough. You're saying something, but you're not too sure if it will happen. The universe doesn't deal with unsurety. It deals with surety, people who know that what they say is gonna happen. So you gotta pray with more, you know, with more assurance, okay, with a knowledge of when I pray, this will be answered. You can't manifest. So let's say you are into magic and all of that, and everything that you're doing is not coming through. Then guess what? You have to level up spiritually. You have to do something. You have to probably meditate some more. You probably have to focus on aligning some more, or trying to increase your vibration of expectance, of miracles, of blessings. And then you'll see things start to flow in your life. You might have to cultivate a sense of gratitude. Okay, so then another thing is you might feel alone. Okay, so let's say you are on the spiritual journey and you feel alone. You are not alone. You are surrounded by, you know, the spirits. You are surrounded by your guardians, your angels, and you are also surrounded by like-minded people. We're just not connected in person as we want to be, as there's not many of us out there, but our frequency is growing and it's touching the planet, and more people are becoming aligned with this type of things. So what I'm trying to say is you're not alone. And when you feel alone, that's when you have to level up spiritually, because you have to see that, okay, I'm not alone, and I have to change my thinking so that I can align with my soul tribe. Now, you have the last thing for spiritually is you go to church and you feel like you do not belong. That's where I started. I started to wake up to the knowledge of African spirituality and African history, and just really what is beyond slavery. And I was like, whoa, I cannot sit in this church. I cannot say Jesus. I cannot say these things. So when you go to church and you feel like you do not belong there, the universe is calling you to do something different, to try a different route, to be more spiritual and not religious, because religion and spirituality is two different things. Okay, so let's talk about how to level up in these ways. So emotionally, regulate your emotions. Use them only when you have something to gain. So if you wanna be sad, if you have something to gain from being sad, then do that. I'm not saying to become heartless, okay, or emotionless. We probably can't do that. You know, some of us can't do that being empaths or being human beings. Some of us can't do that. But what I'm saying is, regulate that shit. Don't let that shit cloud your mind, cloud your judgment. Know when to use your emotions. Know when to tap into different emotions. Okay, you're feeling sad, you're feeling jealous. Tap into your emotion of happiness. You don't really have that, then learn how to cultivate that. That's what it is, okay? Financially, save more, okay? If you can't save at least a dollar every paycheck, or 5% or 10% off every dollar, start with some cents, okay? And then you will see as you continue, your bank account will start to grow, and it might not get to where you want it one time, but it will get there eventually as you just save along the way. And be conscious of how you spend. What do you spend your money on? What do you consume? Okay, and this even ties to physically leveling up, because it ties down to your diet again. What do you spend your money on when you eat it? When you eat, how often do you eat out? How often do you get fast food? You know, those type of things. Save financially, okay? Save for the future. You could also find your niche and start a business, okay? What are you good at? Start a business doing that, okay? It's not easy to start a business, but you can do that as well. All right, for the financial segment. Now, mentally, how do you level up mentally? You choose better thoughts. Again, your thoughts are choices. You control your mind. So you have the ability to choose whichever thought which suits your purpose at that time, okay? You don't have to choose a thought that is making you feel bad. You could choose something else. Let's say you feel guilty about something, choose another thought. Choose not to feel guilty, okay? It's not like you're saying that, oh, I don't have any emotions, oh this, oh, heartless, gang. No, it's not about that. What it's about is just being different, by choosing to think different, by not allowing your thoughts to control you, but saying, no, I'm not gonna think that, I want to think something else, okay, in this moment. So now, also controlling what influences your mind. Social media is a very big thing on what influences our mind, okay? So let's say there's something that you are addicted to on social media, really telling yourself to go away from that, okay? And forcing yourself, take a daily break, take an hourly break, take a 5 minutes break, take a break in between social media if you can't stay off it, okay? We are living in a world where social media is the new hieroglyphics. That's how I see it. That's how they pronounce it, or hieroglyphs, you know what I mean, the Egyptian hieroglyphs. Or not only that, but even in the Aztec Empire, they used to do, like, you know, figure writing as well, okay? That's not its name, but they used to do that as well. So social media is that now. So like, it's like the symbols and things that we see on social media have the same effect as those hieroglyphs, you know, those symbols, those manifestations. Trust and believe that these ancient Egyptians knew the hell what they were writing when they wrote on those walls. So guess what, on social media it's the same, okay? The ancient Egyptians, is like they knew that they were gonna imprint some type of royalty in people's mind when they see these things. On social media it's the same thing. You're gonna be imprinted by what you see, so be careful, okay? So now, unless you are able to rise above that, unless you are able to not really spend much time on social media, or unless you are able to not really let social media influence you, okay? So now we're gonna get into how you should level up physically, okay? So that's dressing well. For my ladies, probably putting on some makeup, doing your nails, okay? Doing something that makes you feel beautiful, doing something that makes you feel good, going to the gym, okay? It's very simple. Eating a better diet, drinking more water. Drinking more water helps you not only physically but spiritually as well. So now, my favorite, how to level up spiritually. I have a million of ways, but we're just gonna get into a few. Meditation is the first one. Meditation allows you to be still and be present in the moment, be aligned with your vortex, okay? So when you are aligned with yourself and you are aligned with your vortex, you are not really here and there. Your emotions are stable, you are mentally clear, you are here. So aligning your chakras, okay? Your chakras each deal with different energy sources. So the throat chakra deals with emotions and expression. Your sacral chakra also deals with emotions as well and relationships. Your solar plexus chakra deals with your sense of confidence and willpower. So aligning your chakras and opening up your chakras allow you to be more at peace, zen, and also to just be aligned within yourself, your energy centers aligned, okay, raising your kundalini vibrations. So now, other ways, you gotta take your prayers to the next level, okay? Connect to a deity if you can. If you want to really take your prayers to another level, I'm not saying that, you know, Christianity and monotheistic religions are not good and whatever, but also you don't even have to work with deities. If your energy is just strong enough, if you focus on building your energy, then you'll be able to manifest things like this without really using a deity. Okay, deities are just energies that we associate, we personify, because we have lost touch within ourselves of what the deity personifies. Okay, so for example, when I feel a little bit low on my self-confidence or love or my passion about myself, I often call to Oshun, okay, because that's what she resembles, that's what she that's what her vibration carries. Okay, so if I want to tap into that vibration more because I've lost touch of that, I call to Oshun. So deities, working with deities could be good for you to take your prayers to the next level, because then you could specify, you could speak to specific deities about specific things, okay? Instead of giving God 10 million requests and expecting those 10 million requests in a month, right? So other things you could do is clear your space, okay? You know, use, say, Palo Santo, that's holy stick, to clear your space. You could also sage, okay? I burn incense as well. I like burning this incense, myrrh, for my ancestors and just to clear my space, okay? And then also, you can clear your space with a sound bowl. Right? So you could do these things, okay? Feng shui, keeping your place clean. You know, decorating your place a way that is pleasing to yourself. Lighting candles, using a white candle, asking spirit to bring in white light. Using a black candle, asking spirit to remove any negative juju around you and provide you with power, okay? Crystals, red jasper, great for grounding. Clear quartz, this is one of my favorite crystals, great for just clearing up the environment. Selenite, it absorbs negative energy in your aura, okay? Rose quartz, this is a great crystal for opening up your heart, all right? Lepidolite is also a great crystal for balancing and calming your mind. Orange calcite, ooh, this crystal is good for your root chakra, stabilizing yourself and just healing, okay? This crystal is great for healing, all right? Black tourmaline, great for protection. Hematite, great for grounding. Amethyst, great for your third eye chakra. I could go on. I'm gonna just say two more. Moss agate, okay, that this is great for your heart chakra and also great for grounding and great for manifesting abundance, okay? And then you have sodalite, which is great for your throat chakra and balancing and calm and emotions, okay? Healing your emotions. So having these crystals around, setting them with the energy first of all, and then putting them on different areas of your body or just around you, or carrying them with you, putting them in your bra next to your heart, or, you know, wherever, men, in your pocket or whatever. These crystals allow you to feel more grounded and more at peace. So getting more crystals, all right? And then going out in the sun, that's also a great way to charge yourself up, okay? The sun gives us energy. And then removing people from our lives who don't serve, no longer serve our purpose. That helps you mentally, physically, emotionally, find, oh, always, okay? Remove people who no longer belong in your life and you will feel good always, alright? So I hope that this video was good. Peace, guys. Thank you so much.